What's going on, guys, and welcome to another Refuge video. Bumblebee was directed by Travis Knight and stars Hailee Steinfeld, Jorge Lendeborg Jr, and John Cena. This film is a spin-off of the popular Transformers series, and it's all about this teenager named Charlie who discovers a very beat-up Autobot, Bumblebee, who's on the run and hiding from the Decepticons that's hunting them down. The story to this film was actually surprisingly good. I went into this movie knowing what I was getting into, but I was a little nervous because the story was done by Christina Hodson, who also did the movie Unforgettable. I did not like that movie. She's also done others that I hadn't particularly seen, but I've seen bad reviews on. And so going into this movie, I was a little nervous, but shockingly, the story was really good. I really liked the way she handled everything. This film, I think, comes the closest to what a Transformers fan actually wants. Differed from the Transformers series, and hey, I'm not bashing the Transformers series completely. I like Bay's vision, but I've been doing some research and I look around and I do see a lot of good points and a lot of faults with those. I think Bumblebee comes the closest to the material that any of those other Transformers movies ever presented. Because you don't have all these dumb jokes. You don't have all these oversexed women with short skirts and tight bosoms and all that stuff. You don't get any of that in this. It's actually a little more kid-friendly than that. I just feel like the Transformers overdid it in that aspect, but you won't get any of that in this. This one's actually true to what the material actually was supposed to be in the first place. Enrique Chadiak's cinematography and lighting work was just done really good. It was beautifully lit up. I could see everything that was going on. There wasn't as much slow motion that you have in the Transformers series. Of course, Bay didn't direct this. It was Steven Knight. Anytime Michael Bay does a movie, you're going to have all these slow motions, which I have no problem with, but he overdid it in several of the Transformers movies. But in this, you don't get any of that either. You just get straight to the point action, and it's fast, and it's really, really cool. Of course, this film was made extensively less than what any of the other Transformers movies was made for. So it was more reasonable. Paul Reubens' editing style was really nicely done. It wasn't choppy. Like I said, for the cinematography and everything, I could see what was going on. I could understand visually what the director and everybody was trying to do. The characters was great. I feel like everyone gave it their all. And this kind of pertains to the story as well. You know, John Cena plays the military sergeant or the head of the government trying to track down these Autobots or Bumblebee, more or less. And there's more of like a personal connection there. And they actually know what the threat is, even though they're mistaken in the beginning. It's not the military just going out and trying to blow crap up, trying to get these Transformers. They actually consider what they're doing in this film, and I like that aspect. The main girl, played by Hailee Steinfeld, I think she did a really terrific job. This film was set in 1987, so you got most of the classic songs in there from around that time, and I really enjoyed that. Dario Marinelli's score was really good. Like I said, the music in there, they used some 80s music in there since this film was based in the 80s. I really like that. Travis Knight's direction was done pretty well. Of course, this is his first live-action film. He's done movies such as Kubo and the Two Strings, Paranorman, and The Box Trolls, which were all animated. So this is his first live-action gig, and I thought he did a pretty good job. The director wanted the Transformers and the effects to look so much like the cartoon that he wanted to stick to the original material. And this goes back to what I was saying. This is a movie Transformers fans will enjoy the most because the effects in there, the way Bumblebee looks, and the two Decepticons that hunt him down, they look so much like the cartoon. Now, like I said for my review for Transformers, I've only seen the cartoon once, but I've seen pictures of it extensively enough to know that I can say that. He actually wanted to stick to the original material and make the Transformers look more like the cartoon. And I think that was a really genius part on his behalf. The character I couldn't stand was the guy that was trying to get with the main girl, and he kept on striking out. There's this whole stupid thing where he would get ready to say something, and then she would cut him off, and then he would try to ask her out. It's like, good Lord, would y'all stop with that? They always have to throw a love interest thing behind everything. Can it just be straight to the point? No love connection or nothing. You can show that love, but it'll be like a different type of love. It doesn't always have to be like, oh, date me. When we're all done with this, kiss me. Which that didn't happen at the end, thank God. But there was a little bit of a hand-holding thing, but the girl kind of backed away. So I guess I gotta give the writers for that. They kind of did back away from that, but I did feel a little bit of a love triangle between them two. And quite frankly, and call me sinister, I'm getting a little sick of that. They can move away from that crap just for like one or two movies. I mean, they don't always have to put that in there. I'm just saying. I don't mean to spoil anything. This is not really a spoiler, but there's a scene in there that involved Optimus Prime, but it never really explained it. By the third act, you see him again, but they don't explain what happened before. All in all, this felt like a true Transformers fan's dream. I would recommend this film for anybody that's a Transformers fan, anybody that actually wants to see a Transformers film that where the Transformers actually look like the original material. And if you enjoyed the original cartoon, you will definitely enjoy this film. Guys, Bumblebee gets a B. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this review. I really do appreciate it. Make sure to subscribe to the Reactor Reactions Galore, which is in the link down in the description below. And make sure to like the Raptor and the Reactor on Facebook, which is also in the link down below. What did y'all think of Bumblebee? Did you like it? Did you hate it? Leave me a comment down below and tell me what you think. Like, subscribe, get reputized. Stay tuned for more reviews coming soon. Peace the rap out.